Hello and welcome to today's episode of pianoTV. I'm Allysia, your host, and today we are going to be exploring five of my top musical selections from Handel, who was a very larger-than-life composer, literally and figuratively. Him and Bach were contemporaries in music. They were born in the exact same year, 1685, and they were both Baroque era composers. So what we're gonna do today is explore what I consider five of Handel's, most of these are his most famous works. There's a couple that I threw on here just because I like them personally, even though they're not necessarily super famous. And like we do with these videos, we'll talk a little bit about the composition, we'll listen through an example, and that's pretty much it. Let's have some fun with this. Let's get started. We are going to start this video off with an oratorio, and of course when we're talking oratorios by Handel, we're obviously going to be talking about Messiah, which is one of the most famous vocal compositions of all time, let alone by Handel. Now, this is where you might not recognize Messiah as a whole, but you would definitely recognize the Hallelujah chorus from it, the Hallelujah, Hallelujah. We're going to listen to it in a second. I don't really need to be singing it. We've also done an entire video on just the Hallelujah chorus. So if you want more depth, definitely check out that video. Messiah was composed in 1741, and the text was based off Psalms from the King James Bible.
An oratorio is a choral work, different from an opera in that it doesn't involve the same drama and storyline. Amazingly, this giant composition is over 2 hours long, and the manuscript is 259 pages, was finished in about 3 weeks. And that really, to me, speaks to the productivity of Handel, but also past musicians. Now let's talk about some of Handel's orchestral music. There are a couple really popular selections, and the first of which we're going to talk about is his water music suites. Water music was commissioned by King George I, and it was created to be performed outside, meaning it's scored for a large Baroque orchestra. It premiered in 1717. It contains a variety of dance music, typical of Baroque suites, like minuets and hornpipes and stuff. But be sure to check out our video on the Baroque dance suite if you want to dig deeper into that.
The suites are called water music since they were literally performed on the water, on the River Thames. I actually chose Handel's hornpipe from the water music suite. I think it was from the second one in D major for our wedding because it just got like a really jolly and jaunty vibe. And I thought it was perfect for like the exit, you know, when you're exiting the church, perfect music for that. Or when you're officially married. And I actually talked about my wedding music more in depth. If you missed that video, you can check that out. It's music from my wedding. But since we've already talked about that hornpipe, I don't want to talk about that one today. I'm going to share with you another movement I really like, the Allegro Andante, Allegro da capo aria movement. It's kind of a mouthful. It's the third one in the first set, so let's listen to that.
The other big Baroque outdoor orchestra performance that Handel wrote, equally famous, is his music for the royal fireworks. This premiered much later, in 1749, and was commissioned by King George II. There were fireworks scheduled in London's Green Park, and Handel was brought on to write the music for the occasion. It was basically to celebrate the end of the War of the Austrian Succession and the signing of the Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle in Aachen in 1748.
Interestingly, this suite is scored for wind instruments only because the king just wasn't a big fan of what he called fiddles. He didn't want violins in the mix. Handel obliged, and the original version was performed with just wind instruments, but Handel went on to rescore it for strings because That's the kind of guy he was. 12,000 people traveled to see the show, and that amount of people, it was just unprecedented. And there was a huge traffic jam on the London Bridge. In addition to that, it was also a cloudy and rainy day, so there were supposed to be, you know, all these fireworks, music for the royal fireworks. But since it was raining, they had a lot of issues with the fireworks, and there were some misfires, and one of the pavilions caught on fire, and it was kind of a logistical disaster. But the music went over really, really well. We're going to take a listen to a little bit from the first movement from the overture. It's very grand. Now we're going to take a look at some keyboard music that Handel wrote. He wrote a variety of suites for the keyboard, with the most famous being the final movement from his suite number 5 in E major, HWV 430. So this final movement, as legend has it, has the nickname the Harmonious Blacksmith. It's an air in variations. The legend goes that Handel once took cover in a blacksmith shop during a particularly bad rainstorm. And the blacksmith was humming a jaunty tune, which Handel was then inspired by and used in his variations. I mean, like most legends, this one is almost definitely untrue. A Handel biographer fabricated the story in the 1800s, we think, but it does sound nice, so I thought I would tell that story. Now here's the story that's probably true, though less romantic. He told the writer that a story of the blacksmith was pure imagination, that the original publisher of Handel's lesson under that name was a music seller at Bath named Lintern, who he knew personally from buying music at that shop, and that he had asked Lintern the reason for this new name, and he had told him that it was a nickname given to himself because he had been brought up as a blacksmith, although he had afterwards turned to music. And that was the piece he was constantly asked to play. He printed the movement in a detached form because he could sell a sufficient number of copies to make a profit. The set of 8 suites was composed in 1720, and they're some of the earliest keyboard works that Handel wrote, originally for harpsichord. It's written in variations form, which we've actually talked about in depth on this channel, using Bach's Goldberg variations as our guinea pig. As always, check that out if you want a deeper dive. Finally, we'll finish this video with Handel's 12 Grand Concertos, Opus 6, HWV 319 to 330. These were originally published in 1739, and the reason I want to talk about them is because I think they're some of the best concerto grossi in Baroque repertoire. And just so you know, like a concerto grosso, it's basically where a smaller group of instruments alternate with a larger group of instruments, kind of like romantic and classical concertos where it's alternating soloist with big full orchestra. We actually did an entire video on concertos, which aren't really speaking to Baroque concertos, but if you want more information about that, I feel like I'm saying that a lot this video. But we've made, I think this is like video 350 something. So, I mean, there's a lot of backlog. There's a lot of videos that you can reference if you want further information.
Today we'll be listening to an excerpt from Concerto Grosso Opus 6 number 8, HWV 326, and it has 6 movements. What we're going to do is listen to the short adagio movement, which I like and I just find very expressive. It uses a tune from Handel's popular opera Julius Caesar, so the audience would have immediately recognized it when this was performed. Anyway, I found it really beautiful, and I think it counterpoints some of the jauntier music we've listened to today to show a different side of Handel. A full performance of the entire number 8, Concerto Grosso, is about 15 minutes long, but I do highly encourage you check it out. That is all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this tour through Handel's
compositions. I mean, obviously he has way more than just the five we talked about, but this is a good starting point, like a launching point. If you want to check out more of his music, you're more than welcome to. And if you head over to the, like, obviously if you head over to the blog, you can see the full versions of each of these clips that we've shown here. Cause I mean, 30 seconds doesn't really give you a giant perspective. And on that note, my baby's crying, so I'm gonna wrap up this video. Thank you so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't already. And don't worry, I didn't just like leave my baby alone. My husband is with her, but you know, she's, I don't know why I felt like I needed to justify myself to you guys, but anyway, I will catch you in the next video. And they were both Baroque era composers.